गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। तो एज इन अवर वी हैव अ क्लास ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन ऑन मंडे, बट ड्यू टू सम रीजन इट वाज नॉट टेकन। सो टुडे आई हैव सेड दैट आई एम गोइंग टू टेक टू क्लासेस फ्रॉम नाउ। ओके, सो इन द लास्ट क्लासेस वी हैव अ टॉक और वी हैव डिस्कशंस और स्टार्टेड द टॉपिक ऑफ सम एनालॉग ट्रांसमिशन, some conversation of digital to analog transmission we have seen, means what is the process, how a digital signal can be in the form of some analog signal, and then again to the receiver side, how that analog signal gets changed to that digital signal, and in this process, in the transmission of digital to analog conversation from the sender side to the receiver side, there are two devices actually that is helping us in between the process of digital to analog transmission, right? So what are those two devices name? One we can say modulator, and second one we can say demodulator. These two things, modulator and demodulator, are helping for the conversion of digital to analog conversion, right? So these were the term that we have started discussing. Now we have seen some diagrams of digital data converting to some analog data, that is a signal. Analog, that is a signal transmission is happening. Now this signal, or basically we can say any signal, we consider first as a sine wave. There are two types of sine wave or cos waves. The signal is basically in form. So considering a sine wave, okay, a signal of sine wave, that is actually three attributes that have. Three attributes. So this sine wave having some three attributes. What are the three attributes we can say? First one is known as amplitude. Second one that is known as frequency. And third one is known as phase. Second one is known as frequency. Third one as phase. So these three attributes present in our sine wave, actually any signal of sine wave, what happens when any of these three attributes of any sine wave, so these are the three attributes that are depending on each other, so whenever these three attributes is going to be varied, any of one of these three attributes is going to be varied, then a different version of the wave will be created. So this is a sine wave. So sine wave having a particular amplitude, particular frequency, and particular phase. So any of this, either the amplitude, either the frequency, or either the phase, if any of this is going to be changed or any of this is going to be varied, then a new form or new waveform of some different version will be created. So the thing is, we can say easily that by changing the attribute, any one of the attribute of this signal, right, by changing any one of the attribute of this signal, we can use it to represent some digital data. So that data, by changing any one of these attributes, we can actually have some conversation. Now In this part of this digital to analog transmission, we are discussing on the topic of digital to analog transmission. Now, in this process of this digital to analog transmission, there are four methods of this digital to analog conversion. There are four methods for this digital to analog conversion. So what are the four methods? We can see, just a minute, first let me okay. So there are four methods for this digital to analog conversion. First one is known as ASK. First term we can say that is known as ASK, that is ASK, or the full form of this ASK we can say amplitude shift keying. Amplitude shift keying. Amplitude shift keying. Right. So this one, the first process. Second one we can say FSK, frequency shift keying. Second one is known as FSK, that is frequency shift keying. Okay. Third one we can term as, that is PSK, phase shift keying. Third one is known as PSK, that is phase shift keying. So these are the three methods we can talk about. First one ASK, amplitude shift keying. Second one FSK, and third one is PSK. But I said there are four methods. The last method that is used here, that is known as the term QAM, quadrature amplitude modulation. The fourth one that is known as here QAM, that is quadrature amplitude modulation. So these are the four process, amplitude modulation. These are the four process that is used for the digital to analog transmission. That is used for digital to analog transmission. Now, I have written all these three, ASK, FSK, and PSK in the same line, but I have written this QAM in a different line. Why so? In general, in basic, these are the basic three methods, ASK, FSK, and this PSK. These are the three methods that is being generally used. Now, this QAM, that is quadrature amplitude modulation, is actually the combination of ASK and this PSK. QAM is a combination of this ASK and this PSK. So that's why I have written it in a different way. So this QAM is a combination of ASK and PSK. And this is the fourth process, fourth digital to analog transmission process by that we can use. And the most used digital to analog transmission is this process, the QAM. The in our today's time, the most used for the digital to analog transmission, the most method, the common method that we used here, that is QAM, quadrature amplitude modulation. Now in this regards, we can see that the digital to analog conversion, the first three, that is ASK, FSK, and PSK, that is the attributes of the first signals. We have signals, and that sign signals have three attributes: amplitude, frequency, and phase. And I have said that conversion of any of these will make, or will if any of one of these getting varied, then a new form or new version of the wave is going to be transmitted and making it to the digital transmission, right? So that's why the first one, amplitude shifting, means it is actually changes on the amplitude. Frequency shifting, changing on the frequency. Phase shifting, changes on the phase. And lastly, the QAM, quadrature amplitude modulation, is actually the combination of ASK and PSK, right? So, and this QAM is the most common method used for today's evolved in the digital to analog transmission. Now, before going for the depth or have a conversation on this particular processes, that is for ASK, FSK, PSK, and QAM, before proceeding that, we are going to have a little bit some other terms that we need to know here. What are those other terms? We have already heard or we have already learned or discussed about the part of this data rate, signal rate, data element, signal element, all of this. Now, again, that comes here. First of all, the term that is known as data element. The first term that we need to know again here, that is data element. We have already discussed on this in the previous classes of the digital to digital conversation. And again, it is here in the aspect of digital to analog conversation. What is the data element? The data element here we can say is the smallest piece of information that is going to be exchanged. So what is the smallest piece of information? Suppose a message, then what is the smallest piece in a message? If it is a digital message, then what will be the smallest piece? Data element means it is a digital message. So in digital message, what is the smallest piece? Can anyone tell me? Anyone? In data element, I am saying that it is the smallest piece of information that is going to be exchanged. So in digital message, when a message is digital, what is actually going to be transferred? What is the thing? What is the smallest
piece? Sir, 0 or 1?
0 or 1 is the term. Okay, you got it. You have almost reached to the answer, but the term, I want the term. 0 and 1 is not the answer.
Packets.
Sir, no, binary bit.
Bits. Not packets, it is bits. So message, that is the bits, is going to be transferred from one end to another end, right? So it is the bit. So in data element, when you are talking about this data element, means it is having a digital conversation. So this digital data is the smallest piece. So data element is known as the smallest piece of information that needs to be exchanged. Data element is the smallest piece of information that needs to be exchanged, such as here, the smallest piece of information is known as bit, right? Now, there is another term that is known as signal element. So, another term with respect to data digital to analog conversion, that is signal element. Signal element means the smallest unit of a signal that is going to be transmitted. Smallest unit of a signal means a particular phase or particular amplitude, we can say. So, smallest element of the signal that is going to be transmitted. So, data element. Smallest piece of information. So in data element, this bit, we can consider it the smallest piece of information, right? And in signal element, we can say the smallest unit of a signal. The smallest unit of a signal that needs to be transmitted. So these are the terms. One is data element. Second one is signal element. We have already have the term in the digital to digital, but still we need to know it again with the aspect of digital to analog transmission. Now, there is one more thing, that is data rate and signal rate. So this term, again, the thing is data rate. Data rate again means that it is the digital data. So this data rate, we can also term this as bit rate because it is digital. So data is referring to some bits. So the bit rate is the number of bits per second. So data rate or the bit rate, we can say, is the number of bits per second that is going to be transmitted. So in the first second, how much bits is going to be transmitted, this is known as the data rate. Whereas the signal rate, another term here, that is the number of signal element transmitted per second. Number of signal element transmitted per second. So data rate and signal, wait a minute, signal rate. So data element, number of bits. It is referring number of bits per second actually. And it is signal, it is referring number of the smallest, we can say, number of signal elements per second. Number of signal elements divided by second. Right. So this data rate and the signal rate, that is another two terms here. Now, this relation, there is a small relation between this data rate and this signal rate. There is a small relation, we can say, in this, in the part of this data rate and the signal rate. Consider that this data rate is known as, or it is termed as capital N. So I am referring data rate as capital N. Okay. And this signal rate as capital S. So data rate is for capital N. Okay. And signal rate is for capital S. Fine. Now, what is the relation between these two? between the data rate and signal rate. A mathematical equation that is giving that the relation between data rate and this signal rate is s equal to n into 1 by r, s equal to n into, that is 1 by, here the term r. So data rate and the relation between data rate and signal rate, that is known as the, wait a minute, this is smaller. So this is the relation between the signal rate and the data rate, s equal to n into 1 by r, s equal to n into 1 by r, where r, if we know s is the signal rate, n, we know n is the data rate, and what is this r? The r is the number of data elements carried in one signal element, number of data elements carried in one signal element, that is represented by r, number of data elements carried in one signal element. So this r, how we can calculate the value of r? To calculate the value of r, there are again some equation that is given by r equal to log l base 2. The equation that is giving r equal to log l with some base peg to base 2. So log l base 2, this is my formula to calculate this r, the number of data elements carried in one signal element, we can say. So this l, we have already know in the Shannon and Nyquist theorem, we have this l. L is the level of signal. The level is the level of signal in that scenario when we are talking about the l in the noiseless and noisy channel. I hope you will remember there that we have a formula for noisy and noiseless channel. For the Shannon's capacity theorem, Nyquist theorem, where this n is actually representing the levels of the signal. But here this l is actually not representing the level, it is representing the type of signal element. This l, it is representing here the type of signal element. This is representing what? The type of signal element. Okay, so here we are getting the value of l, and r is log l base 2. So we can calculate this l with respect to of 2r, 2 to the power r. So calculating the l is 2 to the power r. Now this is the relation between the data rate and the signal rate, that is s equal to n into 1 by r, and how we can calculate the value of r, that is r equal to log l base 2, right? Again, in this part there are another term that is known as the carrier signal. We have one more term present here with respect to this, that is known as the carrier signal. What is this carrier signal is saying? The carrier signal is saying that sender, considering the sender is trying to send some data, and the data is producing a high frequency signal. So a data is going to be transmitted from the sender side, and this data is actually producing a high frequency signal that acts as a base of the information signal, right? So a high frequency signal is generated that is acting as a base for the information signal. This base signal is known as the carrier signal or the carrier frequency. The base signal means the information when a high frequency signal is getting transmitted. This sender, from the sender side, that is producing this high frequency signal, that starting of that high frequency is acting as an information signal or as a base signal. This base signal is known as the carrier frequency. So this carrier frequency is actually receiver. We have the receiver, when in the receiver side, the receiver is tuned with that particular frequency of the carrier signal that is expected to the sender. So means it is again some acknowledgement part that when the sender is trying to send a signal or trying to send some data, a signal is getting generated. So when, if the amplitude and the phase, all the things are not same in the sender and the receiver side, in the both cases, then the signal cannot be received by the receiver. So in that case, the receiver also tuned with the frequency of the carrier signal that is going to send from the sender side, right? So this is known as the carrier signal, the generating frequency when a sender is trying to send some data, send, and the data is going to be in a high frequency signal. The frequency, the base starting of that information signal is known as the base or carrier signal. And in this case, again, some bandwidth, we know what is this bandwidth. We have learned or we have discussed many times about this bandwidth, right? Now, we have this formula. What formula? The data rate and signal rate. S equal to N by R. S is the signal rate. N is the data rate. R is the number of data elements. Now, I would like you all to quickly take your copy and pen so that I can tell you a problem and you people can tell me the answer of that particular problem, right? So just tell me when you people are ready with your copy and pen so that I can tell you the question. So whether all of you are ready?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So expected everyone is having the copy and pen. So I am telling the problem. So the question is, the first question, an analog signal carries four bits per signal element. An analog signal carries 4 bits per signal element. If 1,000 signal elements are sent per second, find the bit rate. I repeat the question. An analog signal carries 4 bits per signal element. If 1,000 signal elements are sent per second, find the bit rate. Now, you will tell me, we need to calculate the bit rate, right? We need to find the bit rate. What is our given formula? S equal to N into 1 by R. So tell me that what is the value or what are the value present and what value we need to find out or what value we need to calculate here. You will tell me. What are the values present here and what value we need to calculate? Anyone?
We need to calculate data rate.
Data rate. So what term according to the mathematical equation?
N.
N. So we need to calculate the value of
N.
And so we have the value of S and R. So what is the value of S?
0.004.
What is the value of S?
1,000.
1,000. What is the value of R?
Sir, S ka value main bata raha
hu. Iska value bata
rahe hai. S is equal to 0.004.
S. But we need to calculate the value of N, not the S. S is given already. Any doubt, Sachin? I didn't get you. Can you just repeat me what the value you are trying to tell? Okay. I don't know what is happening, but still I'm trying to explain it much more. That we have the value of S and we have the value of R. S is given as 1,000, R is given as 4. And we need to calculate the value of N. So just calculate the value of N from the equation and tell me what will be the value of N.
4000
what will be the unit
sir 4000 bits
ha huh? yes yara
so 4000 bits per second
bps
okay. fine so a very easy one just the term we need to remember that is just small tricky things that is given here that it is said find the bit rate but we don't have any term in the formula that is s equal to n into 1 by r there is nothing about bit rate so we need to understand when it is saying about the bit rate what value we need to find out we need to find out bit is representing some the data means a digital part so bit rate is going to referred as data rate so we need to calculate the data rate right again so next one right the next question the next question is an analog signal the next question analog signal has a bit rate of 8000 bps an analog signal has a bit rate of 8000 bps and a baud rate of 1000 baud and a baud rate of 1000 baud baud the spelling of baud is baud an analog signal has a bit rate of 8000 bps and a baud rate of 1000 baud so how many data elements are carried how many data elements are carried by each signal element by each signal element how many signal elements do we need here also how many signal elements do we need here I repeat the question an analog signal has a bit rate of 8000 bps and a baud rate of 1000 baud so how many data elements are carried by each of the signal elements and how many signal elements do we need here so now tell me what are the value given here what are the value given here we have a value of bit rate right means we have the value of n we have the value of n presented here we have the value of bit rate secondly we have the value of baud rate so baud rate means what value it is actually representing the baud rate is representing which term
into the R.
Everyone is saying R into the mathematical equation. I repeat. So I tell again. The formula is S equal to n into 1 by R. So what does this S, n, and R reference? S is referencing to the signal rate. N is referencing to the data rate. And R is referencing to the number of data elements carried in one signal element. So if we look for the question, there is a term saying clearly how many data elements are carried by each of the signal elements. That means this is the value of R we need to calculate. The bit rate means it is the data rate that is N, that is 8000 bps. The baud rate is means the signal element here. Baud rate is referred to the signal element that is S, that is 1000. It is given here. So n and value of S, the value of n and value of S is given. Now calculate the result for how many data elements are carried by each signal element. We need to calculate the value of R here. Tell me and calculate and tell me the value of R. What will be the value of R?
Sir, 8 signal elements, sir.
What will be the unit of 8?
Sir, elements
per bit per baud.
Bit per baud. Bits per baud will be the units for that R. R means the each data element, number of data elements carried in one signal element. So now all of you are getting the result of 8. If anyone is getting any another type of result, they can tell me. Okay, so I can make it clear how we are getting the value of 8. I don't think it is a very tough calculation, just an easy division of that. Now we have the result of R as 8. Now the next part, how many signal element do we need here? How many signal element do we need here? So how we can we calculate this? How we can calculate the L? The signal element, type of signal element is represented by L. If you can see here, I have mentioned that L is type of signal element. In this part, we have clearly mentioned L is termed as type of signal element. So we need to calculate this value of L. The second part, we need to calculate this value of L, right? So R, we have the value of R already, that is 8. Now, putting the value of R as 8, calculate that L, calculate the value of L and tell me what will be the value of L.
256.
So 256, is everyone is agreeing with that answer?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So how many signal elements do we need here? The signal elements we need here, that is 256 signal elements, right? So these are the numericals may come into your questions, may come into your internal, may come into your external exam. Okay, so that's why the formula just we need to keep in remember, and then we need to just put that, we need to apply that and get the result. And the terms, most important thing here, the term, it is not like that always data rate will be represented by data rate, always the signal rate will be represented by signal rate. We need to understand the term, these catchy terms are there. Data rate is equal to bit rate, signal rate is equal to baud rate. So these catchy terms will be there. We need to clearly identify these terms. So that will be very easy, or means we can say we can easily get or calculate these questions, these results, and we can have a marks. We can actually get the full marks here, right? So this, the equation of the signal rate, baud rate, we have talked on this. Just a minute. Okay, now the thing, there is another part on new topic that is going to be started, that is the part of amplitude, means what we were the digital to analog conversation we have trying to start, or the processes. There are four processes we have talked about, right? That is ASK, FSK, PSK, and lastly the QAM. Now we are going to talk on this each ASK, PSK, FSK, and QAM one by one. Now we are going to start with the term, with the topic of ASK. This ASK is actually referencing what? The amplitude shift keying. So one of the attributes, there are three attributes here, that is amplitude, frequency, and phase. Now this amplitude shift keying, okay, so starting with the part that is, okay, ASK, we are starting the topic of ASK, this amplitude shift keying. So what is the amplitude of a signal is varied to represent different signal elements. So we have said that if any one of these data attributes is going to be varied, then a new form of the signal can be created. So in this part, in this amplitude shift keying, in this part of ASK, what happened that this amplitude, this particular term is going to be changed, right? This amplitude is going to be changed, whereas frequency and phase is going to be same. Frequency and phase is going to be same. Amplitude is going to be changed. So this amplitude of the carrier signal is going to be varied, but frequency and phase remains constant for all the signal elements. This is the basic logic of ASK, amplitude shift keying. Very basic. Now, in this part, in the context of this ASK, we can categorize it in the part of BASK. The term BASK means binary amplitude shift keying. binary, amplitude, shift, king. That is the part, or that is referencing the more part here. This ASK is term. The category we can say here, that is BASK, that is binary, amplitude, shift, king. Binary, amplitude, shift, king. So this binary amplitude shift king is a process here that is referencing for the part of this amplitude. So this bus, we can talk about this binary ASK or bus, is implemented only by two levels. It is implemented only of two levels. We will see a diagram here and we will look how the thing is goes on. Right. So first, let us draw that diagram first. Suppose, okay. Now, considering there are different types of levels. Consider this is a level. This is a level. Fine. And each of these is actually supposed representing some. Okay, I will let me. Each of these is actually representing by some data bit. Suppose this is one, then this is actually referencing zero. Okay, then this is again one, then this is again one, then this is considered as zero. So this is a signal, data signal, we can say 10110, right? And considering this is my time or the path for the each of the three, that is considered as a time path, right? So we can, I can term it, it is here as time. Okay. Now, suppose a signal element is moving. A data signal element is moving. So, suppose this is how it is going to move. Suppose for one, this is the thing, and then for all the ones, the things is almost same. The for the one part, I'm drawing this. Actually, it is not looks like similar because I'm drawing in hand, by the hand. So it may be not obvious, but the things is almost same for this. It's all the one, this is the same thing happening. So in the part of one, right, and in the part of zero, there is no signal carrier is actually happening or actually going on. So this is term as also on off keying, binary amplitude shift keying, or also this is, there is another term we also termed it here as is OOK. OOK, that is on off keying. On off keying, if we look at the diagram very specifically, that when the thing is one and zero, so considering this zero as low and consider this one as high, also this consider this zero as off and consider this one as on. So on off keying, that is why it is representing, why it is referring, okay, one thing, that signal, that the time is going to end. When it is disconnected, you will just reconnect with the link again. We will continue the class here, right? So as I said, this one is on. So when we are having our one, we have a signal generated here, so that is for on. When it is zero, we are considering it as off, so there is no transmitter of signal. Then again for one, we have a transmission of signal. Again for one is transmission of signal. So that's why this is 10 is referred as binary ASK or on off key, means when it is the value of the value is high, then we are getting a high value. When the value is low, then we are getting a low value or the off. So high is for on, low is for off. Zero is for off, one is for one. That is for why it is called as on off keying, right? So the time is going to end. Just you will join with the link again. Okay, I'm going to restart the link again.